Hi. In this video, we are going to see about the various techniques that we are using for evaluation in education. In that, first we are going to see about the rating scale. It's an important technique that we are using for the evaluation, and in that case, one person is giving a rate or one person is rating another person's performance. And this is the one oldest method of personality assessment we were using in the olden ages. And the rating is a term applied to the expression of opinion or judgment regarding some situation, object, or character. Opinions are usually expressed on a scale or on as values. A rating scale is a set of categories designed to elicit information about a quantitative or qualitative attribute. Otherwise, we can define the rating scale as it's a scale with set of opinions which describes varying degree of the dimensions of an attitude being observed. Otherwise, we can tell rating scale is a device by which judgments may be qualified or an opinion concerning a trait can be systematized. The type of rating scale include numerical rating scale, graphic rating scale, descriptive rating scale, and this picture shows the descriptive rating scale in which certain phrases will be describing or certain terms are assigned to the trait. The rater enters the appropriate phrase after each name to indicate the judgment of the person. For example, if you're telling about the performance of a student, we can give different traits like excellent, good, average, below average, poor, like that. And the fourth one is comparative rating scale. In this, the researcher provides a point of comparison for respondents to provide answers. Therefore, all respondents will have a uniform point of comparison for selecting the answers. Here we can see the respondent is asked to rate the sweet shop X in comparison to the sweet shop Y in Kochi. So when comparing with X, they are telling how much Y is better or how Y is. So this here also we can give the traits like excellent, very good, good, both are same, poor, very poor, like the different traits will be there. Now we can see the characteristics of rating scale. These are valuable judgments about attributes of one person by another person and most commonly used tools to carry out structured observations. So we can use it for judging about a person, and we can use it for structured observations and make quantitative judgments about qualitative attributes. See, some of the things we cannot measure, for example, ability of a student or communication skill, all those things we cannot measure by using a scale. So those things we are calling as qualitative. So those things, if you want to make into quantitative judgments, if a student is communicating excellently, we can give that point. For example, if the communication is very good, you can tell that, okay, the student is communicating excellently, and you can decide a score for that. And if you're taking that score, so now it becomes a quantity or a quantitative aspect. So the qualitative aspects or attributes we can convert into quantitative aspects or by using the rating scale. It provides flexibility to judge the level of performance or presence of attributes among subjects. That is, it provides flexibility. Guilford in the year 1954 identified that rating scale must have the following basic characteristics, which must be taken care of while when you are constructing a rating scale. You should see that it's having the clarity, it's relevant to the topic, or it is relevant to the thing which is supposed to be observed, variety should be there, and objectivity should be there, and uniqueness also should be there. Now we can see the steps in developing a rating scale. First, in education, when we are developing a rating scale, first we should identify the course objectives. Then we should list the specific objectives, and later we should tell or enumerate the terminal or behavioral objectives, and describe the rating in qualitative and quantitative terms, summarize the rating by adding the scores in order to place the students in different categories, calculate the total score. Now we can see the advantages of rating scale. It records qualitative and quantitative judgments about observed performance, and it measures specified outcomes or objectives of education deemed to be significant or important to the teacher. It evaluates the procedures such as playing an instrument, operating an instrument, equipment or machine, demonstrating a nursing procedure. So all these things we can evaluate. We can evaluate products such as tabulator, responses of demonstration, sample of diagram, charts, etc. It helps the teachers to rate students periodically on various characteristics such as punctuality, honesty, cheerfulness, and other personal traits. And it is adaptable and flexible. It can be used within a large number of students, and we can reduce the subjectivity and unreliability. Now we can see the disadvantages of the rating scale. It is difficult to fix a rating about many aspects of an individual. See, certain characteristics or certain traits we cannot rate. So that is the main advantage. And misuse can result in decreased objectivity. Sometimes the personal factors of the evaluator may affect the result. So there is a chance for decreasing the objectivity. And due to chances of subjective evaluation, scales may become unscientific and unreliable. That is, if the evaluation is becoming subjective, the scale will become unscientific. And lack of uniformity with which terms are interpreted by the evaluator. See, for example, for one person, excellent means it may be the 100% performance. But for some person, excellent means if the student is performing above 80%, that may be the excellent performance for that person. So there is a lack of uniformity. So these are the disadvantages of the rating scale. Now we can see the common sources of errors in rating scales that affect validity of rater. They are ambiguity, attitude of the rater, personality of the rater. That is, there is a chance for halo effect, there is a chance for personal bias, there is a chance for logical errors also. And opportunity for adequate observation. So these are the common errors that can occur in the rating scale. So we have seen the major aspects about a rating scale. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon with another technique of evaluation. Thank you.